So crepes.
Yeah.
Take three.
Hey everyone, welcome to my channel. In today's video, we're gonna go over top three things you can be doing to improve your car photography. Today, fortunately, I've been given the C300 by Mercedes-Benz of Guildford. So huge thank you to them. I've been given this car for the whole weekend, so I thought I'd make the most out of it. There will be a part two to this video as well. So if you guys wanna have a look at how I edit my photos, make sure you guys check that out. But anyways, let's get into this video. So tip number one is to get a CPL filter. I got this from Amazon. This is an Amazon Basic CPL filter, so it really doesn't have to be very expensive. I'll have a link to this in my description so you guys can go check it out. I highly recommend getting one of these because it's gonna save you a lot of time in the editing process where you don't have to go over the car and get rid of any reflections or glare from the car. So tip number one, CPL filter. Tip number two, you don't really need an expensive lens. As long as you can shoot f4, f8, get a lot more of the car in focus. I know a lot of people that like to shoot on f2.8 and 1.4, and that's absolutely fine. It just purely depends on what you're shooting. Having a lens that can go down to f2.8 or 1.4 is obviously gonna be beneficial, specifically when you wanna get some detailed shots. So when it comes to cars, just because of how big it is, I like to have it on f4 or f8 or even f11, just because this means that I have a lot more of the car in focus. But I still get that depth of field because the car is going to be further away from the background. So as long as you can separate your car from the backdrop and create that distance, you're still going to get that shallow depth of field just because of how far the car is from the backdrop. So you don't necessarily have to have f2.8 or 1.4 even to get that, you know, that nice blurry background that everyone loves. As you can see from the photos of the car, I've still got the majority of the car in focus while still giving that separation from the backdrop. This just goes to show that you don't need to invest in a ridiculously expensive lens that can shoot f2.8 or 1.4. A regular lens, like a kit lens even, can achieve the same look as I would be getting on this camera here. Okay, so tip number three is to make sure that you've got the car positioned correctly. Now, what I like to do personally is make sure that the rim of the car or the wheel of the car is facing the lens. This just gives the car a whole dominant look, and it looks a lot better than when the tire is facing the car. So I'll give you an example here so you can look at both of the images, one with the rim facing the camera and one with the tire. And as you can see, I mean, you might disagree with me, but personally, I feel like it looks a lot better when the rim is facing the car. Adding on to that, I would make sure that I go online and research the car before I shoot it, have a look at some of the photos that others have taken, and see what has worked and what hasn't worked, and try and get some sort of inspiration. From there, I'd be a lot more confident to then shoot the car and make sure that I know everything that the car has to offer so I can just highlight all of the good stuff. And I think that's pretty much it. Okay, so those are my top three tips or top three things that you can be doing from today to step up your car photography. I hope you guys find it useful. These were just my kind of top three practical things that I do. You might know all of these three things, but this is just what I personally do when I go and shoot cars. If you enjoyed it or found it useful, then please let me know in the comments below. And yeah, stay tuned for the editing. And that's it. I'll see you in the next one. Peace. Is that my mom? That's mom. What's she doing? You still recording? Oh, cool. So we've been recording this video and this guy just met, turns up, parks his car right here, and makes a ton of noise. I don't even know if he's mowing the grass or he's mowing the concrete floor. Not sure, to be honest. There we go. Take three.
Yep.
Cool. Make sure that the wheel or the rim is facing the lens. Man. I think we've got to move locations.